Hey, this is Michael from Viral Home-Based Pursuits, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to advertise CBD oil the right ways, okay? But before I get into any of that, if this is the first time you're watching me, I just want to let you know that I come out with videos on online marketing, affiliate marketing, which is one of the vehicles that I use online, and how to earn your way into passive income, okay? So I'm going to be getting in the share screen here in just a second. And if you stick with me to the very end, I'm going to show you some unique ways to go ahead and get started. If you're a beginner, or maybe you've already been in this for some time and you're just kind of going around reading blogs, going through YouTube videos and trying to figure out the best way for you, I'm going to go ahead and have that. Don't forget to subscribe too. Hit that subscribe button down below so you can follow me. And you can also watch all my other stuff that I come out with. And so you can get a better idea. And I have other videos on CBD too. As well, I will leave you a free course down below in the description. So go ahead and get a hold of that once you're done watching this video. Okay, and it'll give you everything to understand about how to use things like funnels, you know, why sales funnels are important, what are sales funnels. And I have more strategic ways in that course that reveal to you how to maximize your CBD oil revenue, how to grow your income with CBD oil, but most importantly, how to affect and change the lives of many people. That's a big reason why I'm doing this. It's not so much, you know, money is great, but it's also because I'm able to impact so many people. And, you know, so I started in the health and wellness industry. I started in the back pain space, growing an Amazon niche site, and then growing and making my own products and then courses and stuff like that. And ever since then, have evolved into helping people with CBD related things, health things, and affiliate marketing and in other ways as well. So, you know, I'm just kind of hanging around in the room here. You know, no particular space. I decided to just do this in the room while I was in here. And I also have another video on this. I made an original version of this video that I'll link to down below, which is like the first one, so you can watch that. But this one I wanted to come out with and give you just more details on things and deliver just a little bit more specifics on it. So let me go ahead and get into a share screen here, and let me just show you some of the things you can do. So this is not the only way you can advertise CBD oil, which is Facebook ads. I mean, that's one way, and that's, I think, one of the better ways to do it. But don't disregard that you also have other platforms like Google Ads. You have Bing is a good way to start as a beginner. It doesn't have the most traffic, but, you know, they are in their own respect a good way. You just got to figure out what kind of keywords are being triggered. You got to figure out those little things. And that's stuff that I can help you out with along the road, because I am PPC Google AdWords certified. I'm an SEO because I started with blogging first, but I'm an SEO and I have Google AdWords experience as well, Facebook ads, as well as I help people in consulting. But one way to do it, in one way to maximize your Facebook ad campaigns, is through understanding how to give away something for free. I spoke about this in my earlier video, that to do Facebook ads the right way, you can't just run it to, let's say you're running a depression and anxiety product, right? Or you have a focus and concentration CBD oil edible or tincture, whatever that may be, the supplements. You don't just run it to it, right? A lot of people want to do that. Let's get a product and put it on, you know, put this Facebook ad or whatever ad it is, and then drive traffic people to that offer. And it doesn't work that way, especially with Facebook ads, especially with them not being very lenient on health related things. They're not big on that, as well as like the make money online space and in other areas as well. So you have to be very careful on that. And that's why I believe you should take the free course that I have for you down below in the description, which will give you examples, and I even have more tutorial videos that'll go more into it specifically than I can fill it all in one video here. But these are not these are just example ads that I ran in the past for other offers and stuff like that. But one thing you want to do, and one thing that I love doing the most, is being able to create these engagement campaigns first. If you're running a Facebook ad campaign, let's go ahead and do a create one here and just show you a little bit about how that would look. So I like doing these short 20 to 30 maybe dollar. $20 is good. $30 is good too. Mid-range engagement campaigns where I'm running a you have an awareness, consideration, and conversion. And I won't go through this so much because I covered that in the first video. That I believe I covered a little bit more about that in the first video. But you have awareness, consideration, conversions. And I like to start underneath the consideration tab. And I'll start off with something like engagements. And so on engagements, you can decide between post engagement, page likes, event responses. Page likes, let me tell you something. It used to work back then very well. Like it was very inexpensive. The demand and supply for that was great. Facebook did a great job at maximizing the amount of clicks or the amount of likes you were getting and for cheap. But now it can become pretty expensive. You're looking at like $3, $6, $9. It can get expensive. It can start off like very low and then it builds up $1.10 and then $3. And then now you're seeing that you're getting per click, it's like $3 to get somebody to like your page. It can get very expensive. Nonetheless, you can do it. You can run about a $200 for 3 months of a campaign, depending on where you are and your budget as well, right? There are these little budget things you got to understand. So engagement campaign, I like to do post engagements. It's already on that. So should be already on post engagements. And before that, I structure them in a way where I do my abbreviation for my website. I run things to my website, or what I use are called funnels. Okay, funnels make everything so much more easier, and you'll see that in a little bit here. And I have other videos on that, and I talk about that. It's a big part of the course that I have too, is using funnels. And then if you want to get help with setting up a blog or a YouTube channel, things like that, I can always help you out with that. I have separate courses that I give away for free on that. I go ahead and start off with, depending on where you want to drive the traffic, the first thing I put down here is the name of my domain, right? The name of my site, the name of my funnels, right? And if I'm running something to my website, I'm going to go and use the abbreviation formatted for that. You can write it out if you want, but mine is a little bit longer. It's called Viral Home-Based Pursuits. Not for this one. This one's a different site. So that's RVP, Remove Back Pain. And you can see I already have made some campaigns for them. And then I'll go ahead and do that again. And then I'm going to go ahead and decide what I want to optimize for. Do I want to do desktop or mobile? With Facebook ads, they do a good job at understanding, is it desktop and mobile, as well as Google Ads and other places. But I like to leave it as desktop and mobile first, because that way I can understand better on with my key, with my metrics. I can go back into my charts and figure out which of the ones are converting more. And sometimes I don't know what's wrong with my keyboard. I know if it's kind of slow, but they get stuck a little bit. I gotta go and change some of the components here. It just happens every once in a while. It doesn't happen, and then it starts working very well sometimes. But so I can do desktop and mobile here, and I'm gonna go ahead and I can create a split test, but I'm not gonna do that at the moment. I want to gauge my audience. I want to see how much audience I can get. So I can leave it as desktop and mobile. And over time, what I would recommend you do is you could probably do a separate campaign and run one on mobile, run one on desktop. But I'm going to leave it as desktop and mobile. Campaign budget optimization, I'll leave that on. Daily budget. Usually I do a lifetime budget. And just set your lifetime budget. We can set it at $100 to start. You can set a lifetime budget of $50. It'll just disperse it depending on your targeting, right? Your targeting is very important, and that's what a lot of this is going to come down to, and I'll help you out with that. But you can also do a daily budget. We'll just do a daily budget for now. And something like $5 works. $10 is good. I'm going to start with $10. And then I'm going to just leave it as lowest cost, run ads all the time, standard ad scheduling. I can't change that now because I have other options on there. But that looks good to go. Remember, we're optimizing for engagement, not engagement. Engagement basically means you're just going to get people who, from third world countries, right? That not necessarily have an interest for your, they can have an interest for your product, but the whole point is that you're going to get clicks that are cheap. And why are those clicks important? Because we're going to take that same ad and we're going to run it into a traffic campaign. And then the traffic campaign is going to be for the people who are, more interested. If it's more US based, now we can run it to the US and we can get people to click on a link, maybe land on our site. And once they land on our site, they might not necessarily fill out a form or buy a product. Those aren't people who are going to buy one, but now you have data and now it's firing the Facebook pixel. People are landing on your site. These are the people who are interested. And now we can go ahead and retarget. You can go and set up a custom audience, and a lookalike audience, more so custom, and be able to retarget these people and run something like of a, you know, if they interacted with our video, if we set up a video ad, if they've already clicked on a link and did something, we can retarget those people and run something like of a conversion campaign, and start doing that. Even with lead form campaigns, we can even do that if you're running things for other people's businesses, which I oftentimes do. So we can even name the ad set name. We can do the same thing here. I'll go ahead and do my abbreviation. You can see some of these are kind of scattered, but here we go. And we could put the, I sometimes like to go with the type of campaign it is, conversion campaign, because sometimes I'll have multiple ad sets in one. And so we can work like that, or we can do something like, we can leave it like that, male and female, and we can put like a little interest part in there. We can leave it as is. Usually I like to put the gender and kind of like the interest at the end there. And let me see here. I have saved audiences. You won't if you're just a beginner with Facebook ads. But what you want to do is you want to create a new audience if this is the very first time you're doing it. And I'm going to open up a new tab here and just show you a cool technique that I use all the time. And this works for me very well, where I get to see more data. The thing with Facebook is that they give you so much data that you can go off of, and you can get more targeted on who your audience is. And so I'm going to go to my manage ads account, and then I'm going to go into, this is just one of them. I've had to move. This isn't like my main, you know, I had to move an account because Facebook sometimes doesn't tell you, you know, why they restrict access to your Facebook ads. They're like that, and they don't give you an answer back in return. I know sincerely that I didn't make an error on my part, and I had contacted them back and forth, and they always kept telling me the same thing. Sorry, you know, not sorry, but like, we checked this, but we cannot give you access to it. There's no actual reason for it. So anyways, we want to go underneath here. Remember the three little lines. And then we're going to go to Audience Insights. And this tool here is going to blow your mind. It's going to give you, if this is the first time, maybe you've seen this already, but you can target people who are connected to your page, but we'll do everyone on Facebook. It's going to give you data on everything. Facebook pulls data from everybody, so you can see who you want to target. And this doesn't only account to just CBD. I've done this for many different things. For people who want to opt into my 5 steps to removing back pain naturally, and it's a huge hit, along with other freebies that I give away and my other like low-cost offers, and then other offers after that. But you can do this with literally anything. And so, you know, here we're going to go, if we're going to target people in the U.S. who want CBD oil, you know, you only know your niche, right? You have to figure out who your niche is. If you do not know who you're going after, this does not matter at all. You should stop even watching the video if you haven't figured out who, because a lot of people jump on the, like, let me just advertise to anybody and everybody train. That's not what you have to do. I've been doing this for such a long time that I know that if you do not figure out who you're targeting, who is your dream customer, who and what niche are you going to operate in, it's going to be very difficult. But also within that video and then the course that I'm going to give you below after you opt in, you'll be taken into more extra resources, and you'll actually see a webinar, a free webinar, where you'll be able to see how CBD oil works in the terms of affiliates and in other ways you can apply it, and how you can target what different audiences you want to target. So you want to check that out below. So here we can target this, and we are going to see, okay, we want the US. And one thing I also advise you do is you use Google Trends. Go to trends.google.com, Google Trends, and then be able to type in something like CBD. Let me go ahead and actually do that with you right now. Okay. So there we go. So Google Trends is right here. And we're going to type something very basic. I always start everything that I do. Keep this in mind. This is going to help you in the long term. And it's never going to get you to give up. At the beginning, it feels like when am I ever going to earn? If you're an affiliate, if you're in e-commerce, whatever that may be, you're like, when is the money going to come in? Don't think about how much time it's going to take to get the money. Think about, what do I have to do? What skills do I need to be able to go ahead and do it? So many people fall short in the online world and in anything else, really, because they don't work on the skill sets. Like I said, again, it's not about me, but I just, so you get an example, I expanded from SEO, building blogs, Amazon niche, info products, digital products, to, you know, other industries. I kept moving forward and expanding my skills to Google Ads, Facebook, and in different areas, sales funnels, and so much more, email marketing. Anyways, you want to start off broad, go with something like CBD, and you'll get even drop-down menu for that. And then we can even change the worldwide. We'll go worldwide for this one just to see. And we can see that the trend is kind of going low worldwide, but that's worldwide, right? Australia, New Zealand, United States. So you get, look at this, you get people who are interested and you go to related queries. What are they searching for? Sydney CBD, I don't know, that's some kind of a staffing, I guess, happened. Sunsoil CBD. And you get to see where it's all taking place. And we can even go back here and we can go United States if that's where you're in. You might be in a different place. You might be in the UK. You might be in Australia where you're doing this from. But you can go ahead and target your, and I mean, it only makes it more difficult when the keyboard gets, you know, some of the keyboard gets stuck for some reason. Can get annoying, but I've kind of learned to tolerate it for the time being, until I get something new or I get it fixed. But you can also see the trend is kind of going low there, but you can see the cities, city to states. You can go even lower with subregions and get to know the cities there and so forth. And you can go ahead down here and see more information. But now we get an idea of where they can be. So I can use this information and target those kind of people. So I'm going to go back to Audience Insights, and I'm going to type in something like, I want to go into, if I wanted to do it from interest here, I can go to any kind of industry I want. Right, and you can go into food and drinks, hobbies and activities. You can target people based on all these different factors. And so that's what you're going to want to do. Technology, sports, hobbies, and activities, right? And you can go in through here. They have pets, right? We can do dog CBD oil for pets. There are so many different ideas and ways you can go with this. Fitness and wellness, that's likely the one you'll go into. People who are into bodybuilding, meditation, physical exercise, physical fitness, running, weight training, yoga, food and drink, and so forth. There's so many other ways you can go with it. So one thing we can do, I'm going to go back into this, in my audience manager. And let's say we're doing the U.S. So we have the U.S. Let's actually do, since we're still on the engagement side, what I want to do is take off United States. Remember, we're just running an engagement campaign. We want people to like comment on our post. We want people to interact with it, like it, share it. So I'm going to take U.S. out of there. And by, again, on my other video, And actually, inside of the course, I talk about another strategy with Facebook where you can just skip this part, but this part is important too, and how to do things like with video ads and so forth. But, you know, I'd be here again for hours. Check that other video out in the video, in my other Facebook video on YouTube, and then I also have it all in the course, which goes into more specifically. So we're going to do things like, let's do South Africa. We'll do Thailand. I see this is what happens when you have a keyboard that gets stuck at times. So what we want to do here, I know it's kind of weird. Keyboard. So what we want to do here is we want to target people who are going to engage with it, and you're going to get a low cost per click. So places like Thailand, you're going to get places like the Philippines, South Africa, even Nigeria can work, something like that. And then you want to go ahead and target these cities, and also give you a list, and you want to target them, and you want to write out an engagement campaign and be able to, you know, write out this ad that's going to target them. Let me see if I can work through this here. See, at times it works, sometimes it doesn't. I'll be in like WordPress writing something and it works, and then when I'm over here it doesn't work, and I know I'll have to switch computers but I do apologize for that. So we can do something like Thailand, you know, target all these cities, and then what we want to do is we want to go into the age. We're going to leave it where it is, 18 to 65. Remember, we want to do everything general. We want to do everything broad because we're targeting, and especially in an engagement campaign, we're targeting as many people as we can that are going to engage with it. We'll do all genders, include demographics. We can do stuff like health and wellness, right? Again, the age, it's some of the keys that don't work, like the age, like, and then it comes back to functioning. Sometimes it'll work, sometimes it won't. Let me see. And I haven't had this issue before until like recently. But we can target things, and in the video, the other videos, this is not a problem. I actually go through them and I'll show you how they work. But we can do things like health and wellness, interest here. We'll do fitness and wellness here. We'll do this again because sometimes it drops off. And then let's see, fitness and wellness. And depending on who you're targeting is, who you're going after, it'll be different. But we can do things like physical fitness in here. We can do that. And then what we can do is go to the suggestions and see what it gives us. Oh, health and wellness. There's another one. That's the one I actually wanted from the beginning, but it wasn't letting me type it. Health and wellness. Boom, we can add that. But what I recommend, this, what it's doing here is it's going to do health and wellness or physical fitness. And the more we add, it'll be or and or and or in one category. Now, to make it like health and wellness and something else, you want to do narrow audience here and select the whole different side of things. So what we can actually do is copy the second one here just to make it easy on us. Paste that there. And then, let's do that again. Press enter. And then now what we can do is click suggestions here and then go through them and figure out which ones, you know, we want to have. Well-being, you might even want to go down a notch and go to yoga. Now we can erase the one above, exit out of that one because we don't really need it, right? We're just trying to get the suggestions to come up. And then that's it, but we can keep narrowing it down. What I would do here, the reason I combine more than one at a time is if the audience size is too small, like even 5,000 or less, 10,000 or less, I'll combine them. But because these sizes are big and you can tell here, we'll just keep one at a time. So we'll do something like health and wellness. And let's see here. That should be fine. And the reason it's not giving me the audience sizes again, I'm trying to put in the, it's like no location that's even coming up for me. All right, so let's say I did have one, because it's not letting me type in what I want to type in, like Thailand, Philippines, because keyboard, Philippines, Thailand, South Africa. I mean, I'll list some other ones too, like Nigeria is another one to shoot for. And then there's a couple of them. There's a list of them. But you're going to get an audience size here, which is great, like 430,000 people just off of one location. Imagine now having all those other ones that I talked about already. And that's only a 25-mile radius that's added onto it. Yeah, I don't know. It was working for me just earlier. I promise about that. But again, it's going to give me the audience size when we're targeting the right. I didn't know there's a Salt Lake, New Mexico, so we'll just type that one. But it's going to, when I put in, like I just said a second ago, when I put those in, they're going to give me an audience. It's going to give me a big audience. It's going to give me the estimated daily results. And then now I can even expand it further, but I'm going to leave it broad. I want to go after just people that are going to engage. This isn't like my whole like actual target audience, but this is a good way to start off and you can build off of this. So with this in mind, you can even save the audience if you would like to. Let me see, show more options. All languages. This one is fine because we're just targeting everybody and anybody. But, you know, in the later campaigns, we can do something like English. Automatic placements is okay because Facebook has done a good job as so lately to be able to disperse your budget in the ways that it needs to, because it's going to find the best people based on your target audience and based on the ad that you have out and stuff like that. And we can optimize for post engagement for this one. It's fine. And then you can set a start and date time if you would like to. Sometimes, usually I do. I'll do something like a couple of days, maybe 2 to 3 days to run that engagement campaign. So I get enough built, potential reaches too low. Again, we got to go change it. Let me do something. See how hard I had to press down on the keypad just for that to come up. I don't know. It does that sometimes. It works well when I'm doing it with other things, and then it pauses. But that's kind of a malfunction with the keyboard. Even the end doesn't work here. It can get annoying at times, especially when I'm trying to get something done quickly. The good thing is I've prepared and stuff like that. So let's go ahead and. Not even the U. I can't even target that. I know you're probably like smiling a bit here, but I'm not kidding you. Sometimes this keyboard here, time for a new laptop. I know that is. I have so much stored data in here that I'm gonna have to move over. But here, let me. I could go to another campaign. I don't want to make this harder on you guys, but take up more time. So I'm just going to leave something like Y in here. But because this is an engagement campaign, you wouldn't do that. You would do the cities that I told you. And you would target that. And then we can go into continue. Everything else looks good. Lowest bid strategy is fine. Continue. And then, yeah, no, it's been doing that as of lately. It's kind of annoying. But then we can go ahead and choose our Facebook page. Now let's go ahead and do. I'll do mine here, and it'll auto-populate my Instagram if I want to use Instagram as well. And then I can select, I can create a post, create an ad. If you have an existing post you want to use, you can. You can go ahead and do it in another format. Let me go ahead and show you. If you go underneath here, you can go into page posts, and let me show you. It'll populate it again in a bit, but go to page posts. And you can run any of these campaigns. You can select an ID. You can even copy the ID here. You can just click the button here and transfer it over. But you can even see more post details there, but you can copy this ID here, right? And now we're going to go back. We can go into our audience manager and start from there. Here's where you left off. Let me go ahead and continue. And then I can go ahead and go from there. And I can change my name, of course, if I wanted to. I'm not going to mess with that because I know how the keyboard is kind of acting at the moment. So I'm going to save some of that time. But I talk more about that also in the course. So then you can go ahead and let's go to use an existing post. All right, we can always create enter the post ID here. I guess that wasn't the post ID, but let me see this again. I mean, it was the post ID, I guess it sometimes doesn't populate it. But if this is the very first time you're doing one, you want to go ahead and set up a create a new ad on this. So let's go back into this. It looks like. Okay, so I'm going to just select this one here because it's kind of already done. So we're going to go into this just so I don't start all over. Go to campaign selected. This is a post engagement for one of them. We'll edit it. And, you know, I already have everything on the post engagement. That's that one, the two ad sets. I'll show you how it looks like. see how I have India. India's the other one too. South Africa, Thailand, and the Philippines. This is only an engagement campaign. And it's less now. Estimated daily results has gone down a bit. I kind of just stacked a lot in one. Just to see, you know, it's just an engagement campaign. But like I showed you before, you can do that too, 18 to 65. And then we can go into the ads side of things. And from here, you're going to want to create a new ad. But this one has reached its daily, it's reached this time. So let me go ahead and change the run date time. Right now we can go ahead and edit this because the run date time was expired, so you won't let you edit anything. And we can do ad preview. We can leave that there. And then what we can do is then go through the creative, right? We can go ahead and change things up, but these are already done. So let me go ahead and create a new one under this one. This one is less engagement because I've been barely running this one. But let me go ahead and start off here. And we're going to do create an ad. And see, this is where it's most important. You got to understand, where are you going to be running traffic to? You got to understand the copy is important. You got to understand copywriting is key to this. Writing an attractive headline. I'm not going to spend time, you know, how do I design this? How do I design that? That's in a different video. But you would go in here, do the primary text. You want to have something that is a call out, a call to attention to your audience, like attention, health-minded individuals, attention yoga experts, attention office workers, or something like, are you tired of showing up to work with a bad back? It's going to continue, and then you want to hit them with the pain, like, what's the problem? When you go to work, your back doesn't get better because you're sitting on this chair this way, or you're not standing up enough. Well, I got the solution for you. The solution is that you need to understand how to treat yourself more naturally. And here's more data that I've given, and you tell them, you know, give them a call to action, you put some urgency in there, and then you take them to the other page. But because this is kind of an engagement thing, we can leave it as a no button, or we can do a learn more. We can do learn more. These are not people that are going to convert and go on and become a lead from you, most likely. They're not going to usually become buyers. You can always retarget them if they comment on your post. You can always leave in your primary text something like, do you need my help? See how the keyboard's not working right now? It's kind of annoying. Do you need my help? Question mark, and then comment below if you're ready. Comment below with a yes if you are. I know, see how these, it's not coming out right, but that's what something I'd put at the very bottom of it, so then I get people who are engaging, and that also gives me an idea if they're interested or not. So then later on, I can run something like, I can run a traffic campaign, so now I can get more of these people, and then use something like a chatbot service like ManyChat, and you know, send a message to all the people who have commented on the post. I can automate it with ManyChat if I need to, if that's the way you're going. But if not, it's not a big deal. You can also put the website URL, right? We can put the website URL to where you want to land them to. If you have your websites, go ahead and do that. But even better are funnels. Okay, so I use funnels in what I do. And funnels are basically just you getting more of a personal interaction with somebody. And it feels more real time, and it's more automated, and you can build a stronger connection with somebody. And what you do is you typically get them to opt in for something, and then you can take them into like a thank you page, or the thank you page can be another offer, right? You take them from you give them something for free, get that email, in exchange they get the freebie, and then they go on over to the next page. Then you can say something like, hey, thank you for opting in. Your free 10 tips to relieving CBD oil at work is on its way to your email inbox, but wait, I have something special to show you. And it can be a video of you. Video is better. You can use this long form sales letter, but put a video in there and then be able to tell people, you know, I have a special offer for you. I want to offer, you know, and there's a sequential way of doing it. You might not be best at it in the beginning, but you'll get better at it over time. And then you have a little call to action button below. I'll go ahead and show you that in just a second here, what I'm using to automate that. You can put the learn more button here. And then you can also put the same exact URL inside the primary text, but use something like bit.ly to transfer that raw URL or that this whole URL into a bit.ly link. So it'll be like bit.ly, right? Bit.ly. And then it'll come out as a bit.ly link. And they can click on that as well. And why is that helpful? Because when you go and transfer this over to a traffic campaign, it's going to require a link. And the link's already going to be in the primary text. So that's a good way to do it. So you're going to offer something for free, something of high value in your market that they can have. So then you can earn their trust, build relationships up with them, follow up with them. And what you're doing is you're now emailing them on the back end. So you're working with an email tool, like an autoresponder tool, and that's all spoken to inside the course. So don't worry, I'll break it down. It's nothing, you know, you got to worry about technically. I got it all sorted out for you. But what happens is when they get this freebie, now you can follow up with them with an email automation sequence. Everything is automated. And then you can also do things through ManyChat, send out broadcasts, send out sequences, get people to your chatbot and convert with them there and talk to them there. And I go over this inside the course even more. But this is how you can do it. This is how you can advertise CBD oil. On Facebook, how you advertise CBD oil in general, one of them being Facebook that I covered here. And there are many other ways, but Facebook is a good one to go with. I do want to apologize that the keyboard is kind of like acting funky. It was acting well earlier, but I guess it's just words that I'm typing. The H, the Y, even the number 6. Let's see. It still doesn't work sometimes. But it comes back and it starts to work. Anyways, this is how you can go ahead and do it. So once I'm done running that ad, right, I'm doing it for like maybe 2 to 3 days, I'm following it. And then what I want to do is then let me go back into my ads manager. Give this page. And then I can duplicate the campaign. Or what I can do then is go over to, let's say, this one. Let's go to my post engagement, and then I'm going to go to ads, and then I'm going to go to edit. I have more than one ad in this one. And then what you can do is click this little arrow right here, right? Click this little arrow, go to Facebook post with comments, and it'll show you when you have a post. It won't show you when you don't have anything. And then what you want to do is you want to go ahead and grab this, and this is the ID. Just this end right here, copy it, come back here, and then we can transfer that same post that got a lot of engagement into a different campaign. It's very useful because people are going to see now that you have social proof. They're going to want to engage. They're going to want to click. They're going to want to take more actions and do much more, okay? So that's very helpful. Not to say you need it all the time, but it's something that can help you out in the long run. And so then now we can go to campaigns here. We can even duplicate this campaign and just do a new one, create a new campaign. And then duplicate it, or we can go from the very beginning of the board, go to Ads Manager, create a new ad, that green button right here, and start from there, and then run a traffic campaign to it. So then I want to change the post engagement here to traffic, continue, and then we want to change this into traffic. It's not working sometimes. I'll just do like that traffic campaign, not to mess with it. And then change the daily budget if you want. You can leave it the way it is. And then we can go to appear, don't publish right away. Go to 2 ad sets or however many assets you have. You can create multiple ones. I would always create multiple ones and test out the different audiences and go from there. And, you know, we can change this here just to go to the US. Now we can exit out of all these and just put like your target market. It's going to be the US. So we can include the US in there. And in here, what I'd do, I'd take this all away and don't have too much interest in one category. You want to narrow. So you want to usually have one to test and then create another ad set duplicate the ad set, create another one with a different interest that you're targeting, and then a different one, and then a different one after that. And then just keep narrowing it. One for each is better, but if you have a small audience, you can combine them. So narrow down your audience. And this is where it gets cool. So narrowing down your audience, we can come back to this audience insights tool. And now, you know, based on what we were doing, for example, I just threw in bodybuilding in there. We get data on this, right? And so we get to see who are the people that are interested. 56% of them are women. You can see that most of them are 25 to 34 year olds, male at 39%. The majority of them are women. But we can go even to page likes and see what kind of pages they like. This is where it gets very important because we can target them based on these page likes. And then bodybuilding, UFC. So we can do something like UFC, right? So we all come back over here, go to narrow, do something like UFC. Do UFC one. There we go. So now we have this going for us, and I'll just erase these so I can show you that it's good just to have one at a time. This one was a different campaign, so that's why it says blog and stuff like that. Otherwise, it would say like health and wellness. But we can go from there. It's still too broad. I mean, still too narrowed. And that's because of this one right here. So we would actually want to do something like make them large enough, and then you gotta see how big your audience is. So one for each, and then we can even narrow it down more to, our like financial stuff now. We can go even into demographics, go into financial income, and go from there. But if it's too low, we'll take that off for now. We just gotta play with it and see what works and what's the best for your audience. That's what different assets will help you. Excuse me. And then you can even save it, automatic placements, link clicks. You can do that. I like doing landing page views. It's just more in the budget of things. So then I can go there, go to ads. Remember, change the identity again if you need to. And then we'll do ad preview. And then we can change. If this is one not the one we wanted, we can go over to actually, I had already had loaded it for us, but there will be times where you go in here and you create a new campaign, a new ad, right? You're going to create a new ad, and it's going to give you the enter the ID like I showed you earlier, and you're going to want to click that and copy and paste what we selected earlier, right? We selected that ID from the engagement campaign, put it on here. That's why it transfers everything, and then you're good to go. Okay, and then you can go ahead and hit publish, customize it the way it needs to be, and then focus on the landing page. But this is one of many ways, and then you can take that data now because you have the Facebook pixel. Make sure I'm not going to talk about the Facebook pixel, how to do it here, but you can put the Facebook pixel, which is what I recommend, and retarget these people. And then, you're building up all this traffic, and now you can go in here and do assets audiences. And then we can create audiences, create audience, lookalike, custom audiences, go to custom audience. And then now that we have so much feedback, we can do people who have visited our websites that already purchased from us, even videos. Videos is something I love doing, and I talk about that also in the course and how to go about that. Lead forms and Facebook pages and so more and so forth. And that's for a separate time, but we can go in here, choose content type, people who had viewed at least 25% is a good way to start. I'm going to grab my charger really quick because my percentage on my battery is kind of going, on my laptop's going low. Okay. And then Thanks for sticking with me. And then we can go ahead and do, people have used 25% of the videos, what I like doing. 10 seconds per second is even better. We can gauge information on that. Okay. And then once they view that video, we can retarget them and do so much more with that information. Okay. So you can do that, create a lookalike audience, people who have, you know, Facebook will do a good job at reaching people who are similar to the audiences you already care about, and so forth. So I have videos on funnels and how to do that also on YouTube. So you can also check that out. I also talk about that in the course that I'm going to give you. And this is how you can advertise CBD oil on Facebook. This is how you can advertise CBD oil for one of many ways. And the other ways I didn't even cover them. But there's a strategic way about doing it. Like I said in the beginning, you can do something like you run an engagement campaign to a traffic campaign, and then you can create a custom audience based around that. And then from there, you can go ahead and do a retargeting and then do a conversion retargeting campaign. You know, there's also this. Let me go ahead and show you. We don't need this anymore. See, I started an engagement, and then we can go into traffic. I can build a custom audience around the people that landed on my site for that, and then I can retarget them with conversions and stuff like that. You can go from there. If you have a store, you can do store traffic, catalog sales, e-commerce, stuff like that. I do focus a lot on like the affiliate side of things. But I have helped out with other industries as well and in other ways too. But this is what I would do. This is how I would approach it to build social proof, build your brand. It's very important. Build up an email list too. And you can do this with automated email autoresponders with things like Aweber and stuff that I'll talk about more in the course. But you want to get your foot in the door. Do it now. Okay. Don't wait. Don't think, you know, I'm here to like just not here just regurgitating anybody's information. I'm here really helping you out because I'm doing it myself. And I'll also talk about video views in there. So make sure you get in there and check it out. I have other videos on Facebook, advertising, CBD oil stuff, building websites out. Content is very important. So you want to have content. Content is everything at the beginning, whether you're giving something away for free, blog post, YouTube video, leading them into a lead magnet you're going to give away. And you can get these lead magnets, these freebies, PDFs, mini courses, checklists, roadmaps, blueprint guides with things like idplr.com. You can buy them and give them away or resell them, make them your own, make them better, or you can come up with your own. I've come up with my own, and that's the best way to go. And then sales, you can use a funnel, sales funnel to promote, or you can use a bridge page to give them more from there on out. So I'm using a you can use a website funnel like Thrive Themes, Elementor Pro, Elementor, to give away these freebies. And then on the thank you page, instead of just giving them a download, right, you want to give them like I said before, here's your special offer. Just wait. I have more for you. This is what I want to give you. And this is kind of what I'm running right now. So I'll just show you. I'm not here to promote this for you, but this is, I have my own site too, and I use something like Thrive Themes to create these landing pages so I can give away. And so basically this is just a software service that allows me to create very highly converting, optimized landing pages, and they're already done for you. It's not very technical at all, especially in the course that I give you. It'll go over all that, how to do it very easily. And I also give you a lot of templates you can use for yourself to model for CBD stuff. Here's one of them. And, you know, just to show you, here's kind of what it looks like. That's one of them that has been passed on to me too, but I've made it my own. And then, you know, there's CBD network marketing one I have, and then I have affiliate marketing stuff as well. So you can get those as well if you wanted to join this with me. But you can create these very simple, done-for-you funnels, right, where you go ahead and on the front page, you go ahead and give something away for free. of high value. In exchange, you get an email in return, something like this. They opt in, and once they opt in, they get taken to the next page. And now, instead of having just a simple, hey, thank you, go ahead and download your free book here, or hey, thank you, just check your email inbox, but wait, just sign up to my group. You can tell them, hey, wait, I have something special for you, and then offer them that product. They can click here, and they go over to that merchant and buy if you don't have control of it. If you have control of it, then you can go ahead and have this order form here ready, which if you have the product yourself, if you have the CBD oil product yourself, you can go through this here and they'll fill it out and buy it from you. And this is for a whole nother video on how to set up the payment details and stuff like that. So I won't go over it in this one. I have resources for it. But yeah, that's what you can do. I also have things like my sites here, remove back pain, where you can set up these landing pages, right? Let me show you just one of them. I use Thrive Themes. You can use something like Elementor if you're just getting started. But, you know, they clicked here, they go to a thank you page, or they can go to a low-cost offer of like $7 for more training if you're trying to help them and stuff like that. Okay, so I know this was a lengthy video. I spent more time than I needed to, I think, or I thought I was going to cut it off shorter, but hopefully you got a lot out of this. You know how to advertise on Facebook, one of many ways. There's more in the course, so make sure you go down below right away after you're done and get inside that free course that's going to give you all the material, all the content to increase your earning potential, to increase your speed on doing this, to do it really without any of the technical things that I know I don't like dealing with myself. So it'll be down there. There'll be more resources too, more videos on sales funnels if you want to know more about it, websites, blogging, and things of that nature. Okay. Thank you very much, and I will see you another time.